You know, tonight, Rampage, I guess you could say had a special Halloween edition, mostly with the main event, you know, just like, you know, SmackDown also tonight had a special themed match, basically for Halloween. And, you know, AEW had the same kind of thing for the main event on Dynamite. But what was interesting about this one is one of the participants in the match was Abadon. Now, Abadon is a very unique women's wrestler. She's basically the equivalent of what The Undertaker was, in my opinion, when he first started. And mainly was throughout his entire career before he went the American Badass route. And, you know, aka the Big Evil route. And then back to what he was, kind of like a, you know, a hybrid of both, if you will, later on in his career. But here's the thing. When Abadon came on, you know, a lot of people had their opinions about her. I mean, they knew about who she was from, you know, being in Rocky Pro Wrestling and other places. But they weren't too sure exactly what she brought to the table. And when she first appeared in AEW on Dark and then later on Dynamite and all that, you know, a lot of the AEW fans, the diehards, if you will, if not the pure pro wrestling fans, looked at her like, you know, it's kind of a, well, they looked at her in a kind of like, okay, this is unique and different, especially for the women's division, you know, and the wonderment was, how is she going to fit in? And obviously, as time has gone on and her record has, you know, skyrocketed to basically 17 wins that got her a match, a non-title match with Britt tonight on Rampage, you know, still a lot of people were questioning, you know, exactly what is she going to bring to the table or how is she going to be presented. And tonight, I think, honestly, was a major test for her. And, you know, when it came to showcasing what she's going to bring to the table as far as the women's division is concerned. Now, yes, she being put into this match had to do with, you know, it being Halloween season. So what better way to kind of showcase your world champion in your women's division than to have her compete against a Halloween-themed, dark, you know, underworld-themed character in Abadon. And to me, when I look at Abadon, you know, I think I'm along with others that actually looked at Abadon and thought, yeah, this is a good character to have. This is a good character to have that can have, you know, unique matches and all that against different women on the roster. And tonight, the way I look at it is that, you know, Abadon being in the position she was tonight proved one of two things. One, it proved the one thing that I've always strongly felt, you know, that a lot of folks, despite what side of the fence you're on, that a lot of fans just do not want to admit. And that is the fact that it doesn't matter if it's AEW, WWE, New Japan, AAA, MLW, NWA, Impact, PWG, GCW, you name it. You know, if there's one thing they all have in common, is that they are all sports entertainment wrestling companies. You heard me right. Each and every one of them that I've mentioned are all sports entertainment wrestling companies. The only thing that makes them different amongst each other is the fact that, you know, some companies emphasize wrestling over sports entertainment, while others emphasize sports over entertainment over wrestling. That is the only difference. And sometimes they emphasize this because, you know, the word is the last word in the name of the company. Like WWE has entertainment, so they have to emphasize the entertainment more over the wrestling at times than a lot of people would like them to do. Despite the fact that they have wrestling in the middle of the company name. AEW, Impact, you know, GCW, you know, New Japan, you know, NWA to an extent, you know, and even MLW, they all have wrestling at the name of their company's name. So thus the emphasis for them is the wrestling. Same with Ring of Honor before it goes on hiatus. It was called ROH Wrestling, Ring of Honor Wrestling. So it would always have emphasis on wrestling and less on the sports entertainment. Yes, you would have sports entertainment thrown in there with these companies, just like you would WWE. But the thing is, things were reversed. Like I said, WWE, you know, because they have entertainment at the name, at the end of their company's name, emphasize more the entertainment than the wrestling. Or the companies that have wrestling at the end of their company name, you know, emphasize more on the wrestling. And that's a true fact. That's a true statement that I don't think anybody can deny. But I think the one thing we all have to acknowledge and admit is that even though one will emphasize, you know, wrestling over sports entertainment than the, you know, than the others, well, the others will emphasize entertainment over wrestling, the one thing we have to all acknowledge is that they're all sports entertainment wrestling companies. And that's it. It's just the emphasis is, it's just, again, the emphasis sometimes depending on, you know, what company you're watching is different from the other. And when I looked at Abadon competing tonight and the reaction she was getting, you know, online from a lot of people, pretty much sealed the deal with me that when fans go to AEW, when they go to Impact, when they go to MLW, GCW, they expect wrestling, or they expect, when it comes to GCW, ultra-violent wrestling, and none of this, you know, a Walking Dead, you know, gimmicky, over-the-top personas like Abaddon showing up and basically putting a damper on things, because what they're there for is the wrestling, not sports entertainment. And what's funny, though, is when you go back to Dynamite's main event, you know, with, you know, the Elite as Ghostbusters and the Dark Order in costumes as well, you know, you think to yourself, well, what's the difference with that and this? The difference, basically, is, you know, you had wrestlers, you know, basically getting into the spirit of Halloween by dressing up, but still competing as wrestlers, taking, you know, what was wrestling sometimes in other companies and applying it to what they had in the main event. In other words, some people compared what the Bucks and the Dark Order did in the main event of Dynamite to something you would see in places like PWG or Chikara. And that was it. You know, it was a fun, silly, gimmicky match, but the difference is that, you know, the participants involved weren't, you know, portraying themselves as over-the-top, gimmicky, supernatural, you know, characters. They were still, you know, they were being themselves, you know, getting into the spirit, you know, of Halloween. You know, that's what they were doing. And, you know, I know that sounds a little hypocritical when comparing it to the match with Abaddon, but the thing is, Abaddon's character is not someone that comes out once a year, you know, dresses herself up as a zombie, and then, you know, basically 24/7 for the rest of the years, for the next 11 months, is just a normal girl. No, this is a character that she basically portrays every time she's in the ring, whether it's for AEW or for whoever she gets booked with. So when it comes to her being in the main event against one of the hottest acts they got right now, one of the best women's wrestlers right now in the business, Britt Baker, it just doesn't gel well with them. But to me, again, it's an example of the wrestling fans not wanting to see WWE gimmicky, like, personas or, you know, over-the-top characters in their wrestling company or competing against their favorite wrestlers. Because what it does is it basically, you know, makes them realize that, oh, this is just like WWE in a sense, that it too is a sports entertainment wrestling company. They just put more emphasis on wrestling and than, you know, sports entertainment. And that was probably proven more here with this main event with Abaddon and Britt Baker, I think, more than anything. In fact, it exemplified that. And here's the thing, you know, it's not a bad thing to have a character like Abaddon as part of your women's roster, even if you're company, it puts more emphasis on wrestling. It's not a bad thing because it differentiates, you know, the competition in that women's division. It shows that the women have to go, you know, that want to get to the top, want to be the best, want to be the champion, have to go through all different kinds of styles. And Abadon is one of those kind of styles that's a hardcore style, but it's a style that basically you have to mentally figure out, okay, how am I going to beat basically the undead, if you will? Because it's a state of mind that you put yourself in if you're Abadon. It's a state of mind of you got to act like you're, you know, impervious to pain. You got to act like that nothing can hurt you because you're not alive. That's how The Undertaker, that's how Mark Calloway portrayed himself when he started back in the 1990s as The Undertaker. He was impervious to pain. Nothing could hurt him. You know, no matter what they did to him, he would just pop up and would be like, oh God, what is it going to take? That's kind of what she's like. Not on the same levels, but she's kind of like that in a sense to where you could do whatever you can to her. She's just going to keep coming and coming, and you just got to look out. Like, you know, Britt did tonight. But what this also does as well is that even in defeat, it keeps Abadon strong and it tells a story. And that story is if Abadon could put fear into all the other women she's gone against, and now most importantly, put fear in the eyes of the Women's World Champion, then from a story perspective, that allows Abadon, even in defeat, to have the upper hand. So that the next time they meet, and it might be for the Women's World title, you know, it tells the story of basically from its, well, basically what I'm trying to say is it tells the story from the perspective of Britt of, you know, now she's got to defend her title against Abadon. How is she going to be able to overcome her and keep her title, you know, if it's, let's say, a regular match? You know, what is she going to do? That's the big question. That would be the big question going into that eventual rematch. And that's why this match with Abadon, you know, took place. Not just because it's Halloween and it's appropriate. It took place due to the fact that it's getting ready to tell us a story. A story that, believe it or not, a lot of fans have been wanting to see since Abadon showed up. And that's Abadon versus Britt Baker for the world title. And, you know, basically setting the stage for the fact that Britt is scared and will be reluctant to get back in the ring with this girl. Because she knows one-on-one, she can't legitimately beat her unless she has some help. So it's going to be interesting and very intriguing because what it does remind me of is Su Young's character in Impact Wrestling. I mean, there were several times when Su Young would be either the heel or in some cases the babyface, and she would always have a storyline on camera have a mental edge over her opponents to the fact that every time she'd face them, they'd have to go at it alone. You know, even when she would be a babyface somewhat, you know, the heels would not want to be in the ring with her because they know that legitimately one-on-one, they can't beat her because mentally seeing her, you know, they realize she's already beaten them and it throws them off in story. So with Britt, we're kind of seeing the same thing here. We're seeing the same thing being applied here, that this is just the beginning stages of a potential future Women's World title match between them to where maybe there's a good chance Abaddon's going to beat her. I mean, you have Thunder Rosa, Big Swole, you know, Red Velvet, you know, you have all these other women that are eligible to beat her. But to me, the most likely choice right now is going to be Abaddon, just based off what we saw tonight. So, again, I understand, you know, a lot of the AEW diehards and all that, and the supporters, the strong supporters, they don't get her because basically she doesn't mesh, you know, very well in the world of AEW. But again, one thing we have to remember, whether we all want to acknowledge it or not, is that all promotions, AEW, WWE, Impact, MLW, New Japan, AAA, PWG, GCW, they are all sports entertainment wrestling companies. The only difference between them is they put emphasis on one part of it more so than the other. And that's it. So, to me, with Abadon being portrayed in the main event, or being put into this main event spotlight, it, again, tells the story, or to me, lays the foundation for a story to be told later on between her and Britt when it comes to the world title. And also, it emphasizes the fact that AEW is more than just wrestling. And that it is a sports entertainment company that, unlike WWE, puts more emphasis on the wrestling than the sports entertainment. But to me, I'm cool with Abaddon. I like I like the uniqueness of the character, and I think tonight was just the tipping of the cap of a potential rivalry between her and Britt that's going to culminate with a world title match and maybe a world title change. Who knows? But what did you guys think about Abadon being, you know, put in this position tonight? What did you think about, you know, her potential rivalry with Britt down the line? How do you feel about that? Comment down below. Live chat during the premiere, which hopefully you have. Like the video. Check out the Teespring store. Check me out at BW Rose's Discussions on all your favorite audio podcast locations except for Pandora. Also, check me out at BW Rose's on VEMO. Also, check out my Venmo if you want to help donate there. As well as check me out at patreon.com/BW Roses to help donate, you know, through the two tiers there to help continue expanding the brand. So until next time, guys, let me know what your thoughts are, and I am out.